Welcome everyone to today's presentation at the SIEMS conference about a short paper, The Hitchhiker's Guide to the End of Life for Smart Devices. My name is Sebastian Leverenz. I'm a doctoral researcher from the Institute for Software and Systems Engineering at Kloster University of Technology. And I wrote this paper together with my co-author, Benjamin Leiding. And in the next 10 minutes, I will talk about our approach, which is a hitchhiker, which is a platform, so-called Hitchhiker's platform, to deal with the upcoming new E-Race stream of smart devices. My outline for today's talk is I will shortly start with the motivation introduction, introduce you a short scenario to get a better overview about our idea, background and related work. Then I'm going to present the system design and the architecture, talk about the system engagement process, and finally end this talk with a short discussion about the advantages and disadvantages of a solution and conclude the paper and the talk. So, let's start with the motivation and the introduction. Well, in the year 2090, we recorded a new set record of 53,6 million tons of electronic waste worldwide per year, not for all the years together, per year, which is obviously too much. This picture on the right side just shows a short example of E-waste in Germany of a recycling company, and what you can see there, it's already about 20 tons of E-waste. Well, on the one hand, the term E-waste, it's already a wrong term, to be honest. We should talk about resources or raw materials, because electrical and electronic devices contain a lot of variable raw materials, such as gold, silver, and cobalt. But we have one problem because we have pretty low recycling rates. Even in developed countries such as Germany, Spain, or Austria, we have by law, we should have recycling or return rates of 65%. We have return rates about 40%. Well, so how can we improve this improvement, and what are the problems and the motivations for these return rates? We will have a look at this paper. But especially, we want to deal with the new upcoming amount of smart devices like IoT devices, smart home gadgets, and safe adaptive systems. And this paper deals with the question, but what happens to a smart device once it reaches its end of life, especially when it maybe does not have an owner or something? So this talk or paper is following the design science research methodology. Especially the three-cycle view, which was designed by Hefner. Our contribution for this talk, it's on the one hand, a domain-driven problem description for e-waste, especially for smart home devices and smart devices. We will present the Hitchhiker's ecosystem as a proposal to tackle the problems we figured out in a problem description. The system design, especially the high-level architecture and the system engagement process for this high-level architecture. So, but before starting into the problems and before introducing our system architecture in detail, I would shortly first introduce a scenario so that you can go or get an overview. This is a future scenario of some owner who has a smart home. In his smart home, he has a couple of smart devices, smart device 1, smart device 2, and smart device 3. And in the future, he paid €25 deposit for every smart device he has. Now, let's say after 5 years, smart device 2 breaks and reaches his end of life, where the owner is pretty lazy. He says, I do not have time to go to the recycling center or something to give my smart device back, so I do not want to give it back. Is pretty lazy, and he's not interested in his €25 of deposit because he does not need them. So what could we do? So now we aim for a future scenario where the smart home itself can detect that a smart device is broken, ask his owner, hey, do you want to bring your smart device back? And the owner says, no, I'm not interested, or I do not have time or anything. So the smart home thinks, Okay, well, I have to do something. It uses our Hitchhiker service platform to call a third-party logistic and bring the smart device to a recycling center. He pays the third-party logistic from the depot side from the 25 euros, and he can autonomously interact with the third-party logistic and everything else via smart contracts, via blockchain. So we will introduce all this in the next steps, in the next minutes. And well, we have, of course, the state who operates the service platform and the recycling center so that it's legal everything. Introduce the background of our paper, especially the problem of the events. The background section represents the relevance cycle of the design science research, and as already mentioned in the beginning, 2019 we had a set record of 53.6 million tons of e-waste, and as also already mentioned, there are a lot of e-waste is the wrong word because it's valuable raw materials. For example, there's 100 times more gold in a ton of mobile phones than in any ton of gold ore. So just as you have a number, 100 times more. So what are more problems with e-waste? We have a lot of different regulations in a lot of countries, which is also a problem. We have different regulations in the European Union, in Swiss, in the US, in the US especially in every state, and so on and so on. Also, we have a problem with illegal export of e-waste to underdeveloped countries such as Africa, for example, where they're probably not developed enough to deal with this e-waste in a good way, and also we lose again the raw materials. That's one main problem, the illegal export. Other main problem, it's the user itself or the owner of a smart device or of a device, owner of a smartphone and so on. For example, in Germany, we have 124 million of cell phones remain unused and drawers or boxes at home. The sources are all in the paper if you want to have a look at the sources and the numbers. And what are the reasons for the users and the main barriers for the users? Well, lack of knowledge. They are not aware of how to deal with e-waste or that there's really a problem with e-waste. On the other hand, also a lack of willingness to recycle, motivated by ignorance or lazinesses, or also missing incentives. Why should I recycle my device if I get anything out of it? So, for the design of our artifact in this paper, for the hitchhiking service platform, we especially particularly focus on the two main problems. So one is the illegal export, and the other one is the lack of user awareness. Also, let's shortly go to the related work to previous work, especially to previous work of our own authors, but also of other authors, and the background for the paper, which is more representing now the the knowledge cycle of the design science research method. Sorry. Further, in our previous work, we already introduced a blockchain-based deposite system to reduce VEE. The idea was that you have a device. When you sell the device, it's registered in a blockchain, and every recycling company or recycling center and so on has the only one who is allowed to interact with this blockchain to mark something as recycled and give the BAM deposit back to the owner, which is some disadvantages and a lot of limitations. It also was not based on smart contracts or anything. It was just a blockchain for tracing the deposit and the device. Other related works about blockchain-based smart contracts, you all heard about it a lot in the last years, I guess, especially the Ethereum platform is pretty well known for smart contracts. And smart contracts allow to govern business transactions using a compressed transaction protocol, which is a machine readable and executable. Furthermore, we have the Internet of Things. You also all here in this community heard about the Internet of Things. We have more and more devices that are connected to the internet, and these devices can monitor themselves, and they are pretty smart. They can order, we have a smart fridge, for example, that can order new food when it monitors that it's running out of food, and so on and so on and so on. And another previous work, it's a PhD thesis of my co-author Benjamin Leiding. It's a machine to everything economy and this ecosystem. And well, this ecosystem, it's a combination about Internet of Things, blockchain, smart contracts, and so on, that enables an autonomous machine-driven economy which do not need any users anymore. But it also can interact with users, of course. So let's come to an artifact. To tackle these problems, the already mentioned problem with e-waste, especially to present new e-waste stream for smart devices, we developed the hitchhiking ecosystem. And the hitchhiking ecosystem has four main components. On the one hand, we have the hitchhiker platform. We have a platform administration component, which I will not introduce in detail here, therefore I will look at the paper. We have the blockchain itself, which I will also not introduce here so much because it's just a typical blockchain, a blockchain that can run smart contracts. Smart contracts, here we have a transportation as a service smart contract, for example, to pick up an e-device and bring it to a recycling center. And it with, of course, it registers all the devices and so on. But what is the core? The core, on the one hand, it's a smart home component, the smart home package or component. And this package or component has an observer component, which monitors all the registered smart devices in the smart home and monitors if one of the smart devices runs out of power and reaches its end of life, for example. And then it can interact with the hitchhike platform and, of course, with its owner. And the hitchhike platform then can composite new contracts, can call a recycler or everyone or a transportation service and make the matchmaking between all these components. How does this work? Well, therefore, we showed the system engagement processes also based on previous work, because one of the core elements of our smart platform, it's one of the hitchhiker service platform itself automates, simplifies the return of end of life of smart devices in a self-organizing manner, and thereby supporting the circular economy goals such as reuse, repair, and recycling. And one main element, one core element, therefore, it's the digital smart contract enactment capability here demonstrated by the example of transportation as a service. And the life cycle of this smart contract is divided into six stages. It starts with the installation of the smart contract to pick up with a new pickup request, so the device can say, hey, I reached my end of life, my owner does not want to bring me to a recycling center, someone is here who wants to bring it. Then we have the negotiation process, we have the process of agreement, prepare everything, prepare the pickup, then the device gets picked up, for example, or not picked up, then we have a rollback to the negotiation process again. And finally, everyone gets this money, and we have the regulation termini, and we end the process. That should it be already for my 10 minutes. I'm looking forward for the presentation and the discussion at the CIAMS, but let's shortly come before to a discussion and a conclusion in a short way. For more details, again, have a look at our paper. Our approach is of course mainly focused on upcoming new e-waste streams, such as smart devices, which we use as an example. But e-waste in general, it's a problem, of course. At the moment, we have a problem with not smart devices, but with e-waste. But of course, our approach could also manage, also normal e-waste could manage by our solution. You just see e-waste without smart capabilities could we rely on ID identifiers such as a device registration number, production IDs, QR codes, or and so on and so on and so on. Furthermore, at the moment we have a current limitation of autonomous machines, for example, vehicles, drones, and human logistics. Therefore, a human logistic provider is required to facilitate the pickup. the transport and the delivery of the end of for the end of life of smart devices, but in the future that could be also more autonomous, depending on the development of all these smart devices, autonomous driving, and so on. The Hitchhiker Service Platform can tackle all the problems, like the illegal export and the lack of the user awareness, which was the main goal of OAuthEffect. And it contains also three main elements: smart home component, which manages and monitors the smart devices, the service platform for the matchmaking, the blockchain component, which enables the smart contract-based matchmaking, and of course the smart contracts itself. So I hope I was on time with 10 minutes. Thank you very much for your attention, and looking forward for the CMS conference to meet you all in a virtual room there. Have a good time.